In the 60s, he was up there with Elvis and the Beatles, a millionaire star known the world over. Today, he's down on the ground with huge debts and in trouble at every turn. But he's still fighting. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome PJ Proby. Jay, it's great to see you here on the couch.
On the couch?
Hands off Annabelle.
What do you mean?
I'll be reading a book anyway, but you carry on.
PJ, you're one of the last of the great legends left, you know. Here.
I thought you were.
Here.
What's this?
What's this? Where's that lump come from on your forehead?
I thought that was our last night out.
Look at that camera. Where's the camera? Turn round, PJ. Face Annabelle.
Oh, my word.
Oh, my goodness, my goodness. What? You're in trouble. You've been in trouble again? Tell me what happened.
Not in Fleet Street.
Oh,
no.
It's gone, mate.
I know it's gone, mate. Look what it's done for you.
I know.
It's put you right up at the top, mate.
Yes, that's just a freak.
Satellite disc.
Tell me, is it true what we were reading the other day that you're on your uppers living in Falter Pache in Manchester, in a council flat there, surrounded by toy guns, holding away the bailiffs? Was all this true? You've not gone hard of hearing, have you, PJ?
What?
Did you hear? Tell me, are you in lumber? Are you in trouble? You can tell me.
No more than anybody else.
But it said you owed the tax man £155,000.
You know exactly, because you printed it. With Dinah Dole and I.
Yeah.
And what was his name? Jeeves the butler?
Yes.
Ah.
Was that true?
Oh, yeah, it was true. They cut us loose in 1972.
Right, yeah.
And then I went for £195,000. Dinah, $155,000. You should know, you printed it. And he, he was an actor. What was his name?
Yes, the guy who was...
He lived in...
Alan Lake?
No, that was Dinah's husband.
The one that played Jeeves?
Yes, Jeeves the butler.
Anyway, never mind Jeeves the butler.
Anyway, he dropped dead. Coming over here to pay his debt. He came over here and he dropped dead the day he set foot on English soil from Jersey and Guernsey.
That's the man. I want to know about PJ Proby.
James
Marcus Smith of Houston, Texas.
You got
started
it.
Started out at £10 a night playing local gigs.
And what did you believe? $10 a night? And that's a little less than
£10. And you went right up there to the top, PJ. Yes? True?
Yeah, because y'all had a group called the Beatles and Jack Good and the whole world took off and they coattailed me.
That's right.
They took me with them.
And you had 5 homes in Europe and the States?
500.
You had 2 jets, 12 servants, Cadillacs, and then what happened? Tell us where... Tell us where it went wrong.
Where it went wrong? Mm. I didn't have anyone who could manage my affairs.
I
managed my own affairs and I blew it.
That was a great...
Hey, you like that? Oh, that's what you're waiting for.
Now, there are those among us who would say that your troubles began with a huge publicity stunt when you split your trousers.
Yeah?
That was misjudgment, yes?
Well, I can only say one thing. I was the first person to have designer pants. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Now, if you go anywhere now and you buy your children blue jeans, if they are not already split, you're going to have to pay a lot more for them.
Indeed.
Uh-huh.
They buy.
And ponytails, I invented the designer that, everything.
Yeah.
And bell bottoms and Anello and David things. I know I'm not supposed to say no shoes.
Yes, you were a fashion plate.
And here is designer face.
Oh, my goodness.
Now, everybody's going to walk out around getting beat up.
Right.
Who did that? Who did that to you, PJ?
I ain't going to tell you.
Tell me.
Otherwise, it wouldn't be designer, would it? I own it. I own the beat-up face. Yes, I do.
Another triumph for the publicity machine. You haven't painted that on, have you?
Paid it?
Because you have to be this bloke. You never know when he's for real, you know what I mean? Who is that?
You asked me.
Is that for real, PJ?
Touch it.
Touch me and see. Is it true you're living on Social Security, £33?
Only if you're paying for it, rent payer.
How much a week are they giving you, PJ? That's real, all right. Annabelle.
Yeah. Well, after today, they probably won't give me anything. I'm not supposed to be working, but... it doesn't matter.
Are you on the comeback trail? You're going to try to get back there.
How can you come back when you've never been away? All y'all people did was go on holiday.
So it's still there. Do the royalties still come in from the records?
Definitely.
So you must be getting a few bob from those.
BMI? Of course.
But back to the
split... You wrote a song, you'd always
get... Back to the split trousers. Didn't that all go wrong? You couldn't get the bookings after that. The record companies didn't want to know.
Ask Mary Whitehouse.
Do you think that's what it was?
I don't think. I married her.
Hey, you were married 3 times, PJ.
No, 6.
6. Oh. To everything you say to this guy, he doubles it. He multiplies by 2.
This is my next one.
Oh.
Yeah. Who does she look like?
Well, she looks like your ex-wife, actually.
Well, it will be my ex-wife, but she looks like Priscilla Presley.
What?
Yes, yes, the spitting image.
Who said yes?
And that, Priscilla, nothing wrong with that.
I said clap! Let's go, I said clap! That dumb right, when the Proby speaks, do it!
Thank you very much,
you
see.
PJ, did you have trouble with those wives? I mean, what was the problem?
No, they had trouble with me.
Did you shoot up one of the wives?
Did I do what?
You're supposed to have shot one of the wives.
That's what the old Bailey said, but no. How could you shoot beauty?
You should tell me.
How could you shoot beauty?
Are you going to sing for us tonight?
I'm going to try.
Go on. What about love letters? How about love letters?
Well, my shoulder has been a bit kicked in, so I have to sit on a stool.
You can sit on the floor if you want, mate.
Sit on your head if I want to, but...
We'll hand you over to the loving care of Big George Webley and the boys.
Take care of my glasses while I go to work.
This is a rare moment, ladies and gentlemen, because once again, the giant himself is back. PJ Proby is going to sing for us Love Letters.
Turn this dadgum thing on. Un momento. I have a little girl who I've been dating for quite some time. And, my God, I didn't have my glasses. She wanted me to sing this song tonight, and I would like to sing it for her, if she could hold it for me. Could you come up here, honey? There you go. Boys, could you hit it? You'll know this song anyway. She's the one to hit me.
A love letter straight from your heart. Us so near while apart. I'm not alone in the night. What? And I kiss the name that you sign. outfit of lace for your home. And darling, when I feel the right, love letters from your heart, love letters straight from your heart. Love a letter straight from your
heart. There we are, once again. We have heard the voice of P.J. Proby. And our lovely floor manager, Michelle Waugh, was going up there
very
doing
well.
Her best. Yes. Thank you, P.J. A different kind of music coming up. The world-famous conductor-composer Carl Davis in a couple of minutes.